Okay, today we are going to study the continuation of the topic lesson, that is nationalism in Europe. Next topic we have to study, that is aristocracy, middle class and liberalism. Okay, aristocracy, middle class and liberalism. Here you have to understand that who were aristocrats. Aristocrats were the rich people of Europe. Aristocrats means richest people of Europe. They were came to be known as aristocrats. And they were against nation making. Aristocrats were against nation making. They supported the monarch, emperor, church, etc. They supported because they were the very richest. They did not had any problem in society. Peasants like that, third estate people had lot of problem to live. They supported the nation state making. But aristocrats supported the monarch or church, etc. Okay. Now these aristocrats, but they were in the mainly in the Central Europe and Eastern Europe. These aristocrats were living Eastern Europe and Central Europe. You could see majority of the aristocrats. They were, even though aristocrats were in different places, there was nothing, there was only one thing common for them, that was their sincere loyalty for the monarch or the emperor. Okay, sincere loyalty, their sincerity towards the emperor was common among these aristocrats. Remaining all thing, if you analyze, we can see aristocrats of one place to other place, Italy or Germany, France, etc. Aristocrats, you can see they were having some differences in their religion, in their language, okay, language and their tradition, okay, way of living and the language. For example, in the Habsburg Empire, which consists of a lot of areas, Habsburg Empire, you can see, for example, Tyrol, Austria, and Sudeten land, Austria, Tyrol, etc. People, aristocrats, they had spoken German language, and you can see the other part like Lombardy, Venetia, etc. People, aristocrats spoke Italian language. So they were mainly aristocrats, but they had spoken different languages. But one thing was common, that they had a sincere loyalty towards the emperor. So these aristocrats, another important thing is that aristocrats were having marriage relationship among them. They only married from their own community or their own aristocrat. Even though they were from different region or territory, but they marriage relationship they had maintained in their own aristocrats families itself. So their sincerity to the emperor did not lost. Okay, so that was one of the important thing. But you can see that, so every these aristocrats, even though they were from Tyrol, Sudetenland, Austria, Venetia, etc., they were connected with the marriage alliances. Okay, and after that, so this was the living condition, or this was the system of aristocrats. But during the you could see the in England there was industrial revolution, okay, industrialization also we can say. This industrialization which paved for a new class in the society, that was known as middle class. Okay, industrialization which paved way for middle class. These middle class people were actually they were professionals, they were educated professionals, traders. These all became the middle class. Okay, traders, professionals, and these people, they became the middle class. They were the people who started the nation state formation. So education which brought a change, you could see education can bring a revolution, right? So middle class people, they were educated so that they argued for a nation state formation. So first thing, these educated people or the professional or middle class people, they argued was liberalism. Okay, so nation state formation, for that first step, that started with liberalism, which came from a Latin word known as liber. Liber, which means free. So free, this is the meaning of the word, Latin word known as liber. From that free word, that liberalism started. And there were mainly for the middle class, you could see middle class people, liberalism means right to freedom, right to freedom and equality. Okay, right to freedom and equality was very special for their main thing that middle class needed, that was liberalism means to get freedom. So they middle class, for middle class liberalism mentioned right to freedom and equality. But actually politically we can see political liberalism means politically we can give a meaning for liberalism, that means right to vote for everyone, right to vote for everyone, for men and women irrespective of any gender, right to vote, that was known as political liberalism. Third thing, that economic liberalism. There is another liberalism can be of economic liberalism, which means uniform system of ways and measures. Again the same point we are repeating here, uniform system of ways and measures and also currency. So uniform system of ways and measures and currency, this is economic liberalism.